الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، we've talked many times about the benefit of علم، علم النافع، beneficial knowledge، knowledge of كتاب الله وسنة الرسول صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. And in a beautiful hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، he makes a similitude between the one who gains knowledge and the one who does not gain knowledge. And we know that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Man yuridullahu bihi khayran yafaqahu fid din." Whenever Allah wants good for a person, he gives him fiqh, or understanding of the religion. So this shows that a sign that Allah wants good for you is he gives you understanding of your deen. He favors you to learn something of your religion and practice it. It isn't just memorizing. It isn't just being one who reads a lot or recites beautifully, but you have to practice that that knowledge that you gain. And in this hadith, the hadith of Abu Musa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he reported that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The guidance and knowledge with which Allah has sent me are like abundant rain which fell on a land. A fertile part of it absorbed the water and brought forth profuse herbage and pasture, and solid ground patches which retain the water by which Allah has benefited people who drank from it, irrigated their crops, and sowed their seeds, and another sandy plain which could neither retain the water nor produce herbage. Such is the similitude of the person who becomes well-versed in the religion of Allah and receives benefit from the message entrusted to me by Allah. So he himself has learned and taught it to others. Such is also the similitude of a person who has stubbornly and ignorantly rejected Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's guidance with which I have been sent." And this hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. Ahabati fillah, when we read a hadith like this of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is as if we never heard this hadith, because we are not reminded often of the true benefit of da'wah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not calling to ourselves, not calling to our getting the most likes, not calling to this or calling to that, but really truly calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah bless us with the ikhlas wa tabad, ameen ya rabbil alameen. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a similitude between the one who chooses ignorance over guidance, who chooses jahil over hidayah, who chooses to not learn and not come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through their knowledge and their ibadah, but instead they choose to remain stagnant and ignorant. And you see that ignorance does not produce fruit, but knowledge produces fruit. So this is very important for us to learn our religion, to practice our religion, to strive to come closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, and be of those who adhere to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that can only be done through ilman nafiya. So the da'i ilallah, the alim, the sheikh, that they are producing fruit for others to partake from. And that fruit is the knowledge of the book and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and hikmah. And hikmah means to put everything in its proper place. All of this understanding, this fiqh fi deen, it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah bless us with ilm al nafi, rizqan tayyib wa amal mutaqabbilan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us tawfiq in everything that we do, which is khair. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from everything that we do and that we earn from shar. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.